Today, I'm going to show you how to set up the automatic depositor by Truffly Made. To remove the hopper, there is two little triggers on each side, here and here. All you have to do is to pull both triggers and lift the hopper. There's a handle in the back in order to secure it. Now that the hopper is removed, we can access to the pistons. To do that, just lift the top panels, which will lock automatically. Now that we can see our piston, we can decide to adjust and remove any piston that is extra to our production. To do so, simply press the bottom of the piston and the back of it will pop out. We can now put the hopper back on top of the base. Make sure you hear the click. We want now to align every single nozzle with the cavities. In order to do so, simply move the nozzles manually to align them with your cavities. Now that our pistons are properly aligned with the cavities, we can select the mold on our software. Up to 15 different programs can be entered within the software, which allow you great flexibility. Select now the desired mold. And confirm the amount of piston set up. Also, confirm that the assembly has been properly locked up. Set up your temperature. And last, engage the engine. Our machine is now ready to start and will increase in temperature to reach the requested temperature. Also, the requested temperature can be adjusted during production. We can also manually adjust the amount or the volume dispensed by each piston. All this can be done live during production to quickly adjust the machine. Now that the machine reached the requested temperature, we are ready to fill our hopper with any product ranging from tempered chocolate to hard candy. Make sure to close the lid once the product is in within the hopper, and we can now start our tray and the depositing process will start. A mold can be filled between 20 and 35 seconds, depending on what speed setting you're on. Thank you. Once production has been achieved, it's now time to clean the depositor. Pull each trigger on each side of the hopper and lift the hopper from the front in order to remove it. We want to remove every single piston after use. The best way to clean the pistons is to disassemble them and throw them in boiling water for a few minutes. Hard candy, especially hard to clean inside of the pistons. So properly ensure every single pistons are thoroughly cleaned. You can now reassemble all your piston without forgetting to grease them and reassemble every single one of them in within the depositor. In order to prevent inconsistency during the depositing process, we recommend to properly and thoroughly clean every single piston after each use. In order to do so, wait until your piston cooling down and then disassemble by removing the top part. Properly clean the valve stopper. This valve stopper must be white, clear, with a clean shape. If this element become dark or brownish or start to lose its shape, it is time to change this part. As well as the little O-rings, which are located in the front of the piston on top, as well as two small ones located inside. These components must be changed often, depending on what type of product you're making. Also, before reassembling the piston, it is very important to grease them. Make sure you use a quality cooking spray in order to properly lubricate the piston. I hope this presentation has been helpful for you and your team. If you need more information, please visit our website at www.truffleymade.com. Also, you can reach out to us via email at info@truffleymade.com. Thank you.